The cost of accidents at work are direct costs, indirect costs, and unknown costs. Let's start with direct costs, which is also known as insured costs. Direct costs for accidents are usually considered those costs covered by insurance, workers' compensation, medical treatment, employer's liability, public liability, product liability, motor vehicle, etc. comes under direct costs. The average direct cost depends on the type of the injury or illness. For example, minor accidents cost less than the major accidents at the workplace. As per Occupational Health and Safety Administration, the direct costs usually range from $1,000 to $20,000. A good round figure to use when estimating all lost time workplace injuries is $40,000. This changes as the number of accidents increases. Means the more accidents, the higher the insurance. We can compare direct and indirect costs as iceberg. Direct costs are just the tip of the iceberg. What we don't see is the bottom part of the iceberg, which is indirect costs, also known as uninsured costs. Indirect costs are additional costs associated with an accident. What is important to realize is that indirect costs are usually greater than direct costs. Indirect costs are 2 to 10 times expensive than direct costs. Another important point is that unlike direct costs, indirect costs are uninsured, which means they come right out of corporate pocketbook. The company pays the indirect cost. These are the costs that can drive a company into the red. From an accounting perspective, when we say in the red or into the red or red company, it generally means that the business is in loss. The income statement of a company shows whether a business is in green, black, or red. Let's see some examples of indirect cost. Lost production time. Because of the emergency due to accident, the production must be stopped. Productive time lost by an injured employee. The injured employee must be given immediate medical attention. Productive time lost by employees and supervisors helping the accident victim. Cleaning the accident site and start of operations interrupted by an accident. When accident happens in workplace, the injured worker may be hospitalized for months, and after medical attention at hospital, he might need 2 to 9 months of therapy depending on the severity of the accident and health condition of the worker. During the recovery time, the machine on which the accident took place cannot be left idle, which is huge loss. So company must hire new employee and train him or her on that machine until the return of injured worker. It takes time and money to repair or replace the damaged equipment, materials or other property. Cost of continuing all or part of the employee's wages plus compensation. Reduced morale among your employees, and perhaps this results in lower efficiency of workers. Cost of completing paperwork generated by the accident. And there could be Occupational Safety and Health Administration penalties. Now let's see what is unknown cost. Unknown costs can be related to accident at workplace. You will hear or read a lot about direct and indirect costs associated with workplace accidents, but there are other costs that are difficult or impossible to measure that may have a fatal impact on the success of the company. We are talking about the unknown or unknowable costs of workplace accidents, which is morale and reputation. When a serious accident or fatality occurs in the workplace, a very basic negative message may be sent to employees. message like management does not care. The message may be subtle, but it may be there. In many instances, employee morale suffers, and this usually negatively impacts the quantity and quality of the work they perform. Employee turnover, or employees who resign their jobs, usually increases after a serious accident, and even more number of people resign their job after a fatality. Another factor that might affect the long-term success of a company is that of reputation. What do employees and the members of the local community think about a company that does not keep its workplace safe and healthful? What message about a company does the family of accident or fatality victim send to their relatives, friends, and neighbors? Will a company with a poor accident record maintain competitive advantage when hiring the best qualified people? The cost to employers is financial alone. However, depending on who is at fault and the size of the company, the reputational damage can also be significant and long-term. One must always remember the reputation of a company is a reflection of its public image and must be considered as an important factor influencing its success. Accidents must be prevented and safety should be given priority. Because of three major reasons, they are human, legal, and economic reasons. First, human reasons, to prevent suffering and to maintain quality of life. No one should be expected to risk life and limb in return for a contract of employment. Next is legal reasons. There are various policies and laws like Health and Safety at Work Act 1974. Because failures can lead to enforcement notices to the company, prosecution of head of the company or employers, civil actions for compensation for the accidents that took place and for the offenses. Finally, due to economic reasons, due to direct, indirect, and unknowable costs of accident in workplace, also the company could enter into the red zone or state of bankruptcy. Now let's see some examples of accident costs. Piper Alpha accident. The Piper Alpha was an oil platform located in the North Sea, Scotland. When Piper Alpha accident took place, 167 men died. 61 workers escaped and survived. It is estimated that property damage was €1.7 billion. This €1.7 billion was total insured loss, making Piper Alpha accident one of the costliest man-made catastrophes ever. Another example is Grangemouth BP refinery fire in 1987. The incident took place due to multiple safety issues. Fatalities were two workers, a fitter and a rigger, were engulfed by the flames and killed. Two workers managed to escape the fire. The BP refinery fell short of expectations for the management of safety and environmental performances. Thus, was heavily fined for multiple safety and health offenses. It was estimated about €50 million was lost in property damage. It costed €50 million more due to business interruption. Let's see two case studies on accident cost in the workplace to realize the difference between insured and uninsured costs. First, a construction site. A company was given a project to construct a supermarket in 12 months. The total losses due to an accident during the project was €700,000, which equates to 8.5% of tender value. When we compare direct and indirect costs, insured to uninsured ratio is 1:11. Another case study is a creamery. A creamery which makes dairy products had total staff of 340 members. Total annual cost due to accidents is about 975,000 euros, which equates to 1.4% of total operating costs. When we compare insured and uninsured cost of accidents, it is 1:36, a massive difference. Is good health and safety good business? Safety is, without doubt, the most crucial investment we can make. And the question is not what it costs us, but what it saves. Prevention is not only better, but cheaper than cure. Profits and safety are not in competition. On the contrary, safety at work is good business. We recognize the importance of costing loss events as part of total safety management. Good safety is good business. Thanks for watching.